long time again. But it's Laura Jean and my continued adventure. I have not had a lot of decline in function over the last half year. Let me see. The last two ALS clinics, my breathing has remained around the low to mid 20s, which is pretty low. Forced vital capacity. And let me see, I've lost a little bit of muscle in my hand and control in my arm, my left arm, which has been stronger. I'm right dominant normally. And my core has been a little bit weaker. But overall, that's acceptable. I've definitely slowed down in my progression. And I haven't been doing a whole lot over the last half year. I've cut down my supplements. I've been doing A, B, C, D, and E. Magnesium, I like the 3 and 8. Been doing Protandim. Let me see. Zinc, NAC, potassium. I use nutmeg essential oil on my hands at night to help me sleep. That seems to help. I do it neat, which means just straight, which is strong. Most people probably would not recommend that. At nights when I really have trouble sleeping, well, the next night I take some sour cherry juice, just a, quarter cup or so, eighth of a cup, and that usually does help. Started doing some Orgain plant-based protein powder because I felt like I was losing weight. We'll see what that's doing. I get weighed at my clinic next week. I'm doing dewormer, mostly because I get these weird brain sensations and stomach pain, and it seems to be worse around the spring and the fall, and it seems to go away with dewormer. So it's just an herbal mix that I made myself of black walnut hull and Artemisia annua, which is a wormwood, and cloves. It's nasty. I do green tea some, and I've been liking that. I have not been able to handle caffeine, so that's kind of new for me. And the biggies for me, Bible reading, and I've recently started praying in tongues, which is something I did when I was younger and I stopped doing because I thought, I wasn't sure if it was really biblical. But I am doing it again, and I feel like not only is it something that draws me closer to God, but I feel like it also is a benefit to me physically. So that's what I've been doing lately. Breathing also, the breathing feels pretty good. I've noticed that during the second half of my menstrual cycle, the luteal phase, I have a harder time breathing. So I just kind of know that going in, and then toward the end I start doing castor oil packs because they seem to increase, hurry up, bring back on the menstrual cycle, and improve my breathing, which is a big deal to me. My breathing also, I seem to get these weird events where I wake up and there's a circuit disconnect alarm on my Trilogy, and I feel like I'm gasping for breath and the machine is fighting me. I don't know if it's a problem with the machine or a problem with me, but I suspect it's a problem with me because I had the same problem with my BiPAP, which is totally different make and totally different method. So we're gonna get that checked out. But the apnea has been getting worse since I started propolis. I'm still taking the propolis, but just interesting to me. I feel like it's more of a breathing regulation issue. I don't know why certain times I have a harder time regulating my breathing, because it does seem to come in waves, and I haven't really found out what exactly causes those waves, except for the propolis makes it worse. Let me see. Aside from the supplements, the only alternative therapy I'm doing right now is still the bee venom therapy. I've been at 10 stings for 4 months. I have noticed some retracing where it brings up symptoms I've had before and then makes them worse and then they start to go away. Mostly just mouth ulcers and actually panic attacks, which I never knew that I had. I just thought a couple years ago that certain people that stressed me out made me shake. But I started getting them recently around people that did not stress me out. And I've talked to several people and the symptoms do line up with panic attacks. And just very interesting. Again, makes me wonder like what misregulation is going on there. But they're going away and mostly are not there anymore. I found that when I miss a vitamin C dose, I take 1,000 four times a day. If I miss that, then I do have anxiety that comes up, which is usually a precursor to the attacks. And the attacks just look like shaking for me and then increased anxiety. So I just make sure I take my vitamin C. And I found out if I double that vitamin C and take 2,000 four times a day, it's really bad for me. Headaches and, yeah, bad idea, constipation. Sorry, too much information. There might be a couple other things I've retraced with the bee venom therapy, but I'm not sure about those, so. Possibly urinary urgency and tachycardia, but they might have been due to other things. I'm not really sure if it was the bees affecting those. So right now I'm going to continue this therapy. I actually would like to try an experimental therapy, sorry about the shaking, of hydrocortisone and penicillin G. I've asked one neurologist, I'm asking a second one. So right now it's just finding someone that would be willing to do an experimental treatment on me. The results were from a very small case study with 3 people. And they halted progression and regained limited function. And I've talked to one other person online who had similar results. So, a little nervous about, I think you need a central catheter for that. 20 days of high dose IV treatment. I probably need to be in a hospital. There's risk of respiratory depression coming off the hydrocortisone. So I'm hopeful that somewhere I can find a neurologist who is willing to go out on a limb for me. And hopefully someone that doesn't live too far away so I can stay near my family. What else have I got for you? I also would really like to start doing exercises in a pool and try to maintain muscle mass. I've talked with people who have found that that really helps their diaphragm. I've talked with a number of people who have halted their progression. Some who've had limited reversal, and at least one who's had complete reversal after bulbar onset and not being able to talk. So it's not common to have ALS reversals, but I've talked to enough people online and heard detailed accounts of their stories that I know that there is a mechanism out there, maybe different for different people, but that there can be a workable therapy for ALS. And that brings me to the God in me part of my talk. So for those of you who are interested, you can keep listening. Almost shortly after the last video, I really started praying more about healing and about God revealing a workable therapy for ALS. And I asked him to show me one. And that night I got a dream that I felt was an answer to that. Unfortunately, it's a very simple dream and I don't understand it. So I guess now my step is asking God for an interpretation of the dream and just keeping my eyes open. Basically, it was a box with three or four rows of maybe 10 to 12 golf ball size holes, and having to do with the neck and having to do with permeability. And that's it. I have nothing else. That's all I got. So, for what it's worth, I know that there are a lot of Christians who do not believe that the miraculous is for today, but that is something that I do believe strongly, that the gifts, the miraculous gifts, will continue until we no longer know in part, and until we no longer see through a glass darkly, but until we see the Lord face to face. And that's not yet. So until then, we are to desire the spiritual gifts, especially that we might prophesy, and the higher gifts, which seem to include the gifts of speaking in tongues. And I know that alienates a lot of people from me. I know not everybody agrees with that. This has been kind of a turnaround for me, change in perspective, but I have always believed that God answers prayers and that he performs miracles. It's little things, and it might not mean much to you guys, but when I was 5, we never won a baseball game, and I really wanted to. Of course, I had a bad attitude after every game, and I wasn't really honest when I said good game to the other kids. So one time, I decided to ask God to let us win a game, and we lost it. And I said good game, and I meant it that time, all the kids. And I asked him again, and we won the next game. I think it was the only game we ever won. Just a 5-year-old's little prayers. When I was older, maybe 8 or something, somebody stole my brother's bike, and I prayed that God would help me find it. And I looked all over our neighborhood, ran down to our creek, and I found it among the trees in the creek. Again, not a big deal. to most people, but to me it was. My parents separated when I was a preteen. I prayed for them for over 20 years. I felt peace after maybe like 25 years of prayer. And a couple years later, my parents got back together. I'm not saying that every single thing I've prayed for, I've got the answer I'd wanted. As a wise parent, I don't give my children everything they ask for, but I do delight to give them what they ask for. And so I ask God for healing, and I ask Him for the miraculous, and I expect it. I think if anything in our culture, it's not that we are too involved in the miraculous, but it's that we ignore and don't embrace enough the verses that tell us to ask and that we will receive. To ask in faith, believing that it will be done for us. Those are difficult verses. And I'm not saying that they're just a free gift card to get every little wish in your heart. But they're not throwaway verses either. And that's been a challenge to me lately. So I know there's a school of thought that if you're relying on God, then why seek doctors? But the Bible says that even in heaven, that the leaves of the trees were for the healing of the nations. So good grief, when it's perfect, if we're using plants for health, wouldn't it make sense that natural things in the world around us are put there for our benefit? I don't know, it makes sense to me. When you think about Naaman, sorry, I'm getting brain a blank. Being healed of leprosy from river water and mud healing a blind man's eyes, you know, like, these are natural things. I mean, if God is able to create out of nothing and able to heal miraculously with nothing, He's able to do it with things too. And I don't think there's anything wrong with being healed through a doctor or getting a therapy from God for healing so that all people can get healed just by taking whatever pill or substance. I'll end with a couple things. Just want to say a brief note on blessing people who are in a difficult situation, like me, like a diagnosis like this. Blessing them with constructive conflict. It's hard for anyone to knowingly bring about stress into my life. People try to make things easy for me. So when I do something wrong, or when something needs to change in my life or in my relationship with others, sometimes it's difficult to bring up with me. And I understand that. But, you know, I'm still living life, and there's a certain amount of stress and conflict that is necessary in order to have close relationships. And so I just want to encourage those of you who deal with people like me to maintain your constructive conflict. Work through the difficult things, because if you don't, you will grow apart and you won't have the close relationship. And that is so important to a person in my situation. Sometimes the conflict is a blessing. So, to close up, not every day is easy. It's a lot about this is that is hard. My husband is Mr. Incredible. And yet, we are on a great adventure. And we are blessed with so many things. My distracting and exciting and devious children. Getting close relationship with my husband. Seeing the beauty of the gardens. The sunshine. Life has been good. I've been blessed by family that cares. Blessed by our church family. So I'm just blessed with an adventure here, set up by God. And I'm looking forward to what is next. He's given me everything that pertains to life and godliness. And with all that he has given to me, how will he not also give me all things? I want to read you a few verses that brought me to tears maybe a month ago. Really helped me. I hope they're an encouragement to you. Romans 5:1-5. Therefore, since we have been justified, made right with God by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him we have also obtained access by faith into the grace in which we stand. And we rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. Not only that, but we rejoice in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope, sounding a little bit like a Star Wars movie, does not put me to shame, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. It's the relationship, our hope, it comes down to our hope that we have. Because we have this relationship. May you be encouraged. Till next time. Later. I have to find somebody to turn off the video.